I'm originally from Fermoy, County Cork, but I grew up in Wexford, just outside of Enniscorthy, small little village of Bree. And then moved back to Cork, where I learned to sail when I was 17 years old. And so pretty much Cork's been my home back home in Ireland when I'm back home these days. But I currently live in the south coast of the UK. I hadn't sailed until I was 17, but one thing I had done is I'd stepped on board NCB Ireland, an Irish entry in the race when I was 14 years old. When I saw what the guys were about to do and race this massive machine around the world, and the whole sense of adventure racing around the world kind of captured me. And it wasn't until I was 17 I had a first opportunity to go for a sail. Loved it, and pretty much sailed every day since for 2-3 years non-stop in Cork Harbour. This will be my my sixth lap of the world and my fifth Dhabi Ocean race. I did the first one in 2001. It was the 2001-2002 race with an Australian entry, News Corporation. We lived and trained out of New Zealand for a year and then competed in the 9-month long race around the world. So that was my first Volvo Ocean race. It's been going very well so far. We've had a very intense and long build-up and training period where we covered some 15,000 miles, including two transatlantics, round Britain and Ireland race, where we won the race and broke the record. And then down to Alicante for the start of the race. The very first race in Alicante, part of the Volvo, was the import race, which we came second in. And then we went on to win the first leg from Alicante to Cape Town. So that's a huge boost for us as a team. It kind of consolidates all our work and everything we've been training and leading up to over the months before the race. But and now we're in Abu Dhabi after leg two, so we had a third place coming into this leg. Which we're pretty happy with. It's a one design fleet, and to us, if we can keep consistency and keep at the top on the podium for every leg, we'll overall be in a pretty good place, I'd imagine, by the end of the race. So competition is hotting up. It's definitely getting tougher as legs go on. It's going to continue to do that. The differences between the boats or between the crews are getting smaller. But we're still on top of the game, and we just got to keep it there for the next 6 months. We've got one Abu Dhabi crew member, Adil Khalid, and then we've got seven nationalities amongst the rest of the eight crew. So we're a very, very international crew. We've got Australian, New Zealand, American, English, and Spanish, and I'm the only Irish here at the moment.
Justin's been complaining of sore teeth for a couple of days now, and he's been on ibuprofen quite a lot.
Have you ever done this before?
Not on a human, not on an animal either.
I'm one of these people that never had a toothache in my life, but of course, day two of a 23-day leg, I've finally appreciated what everybody's going on about when they've won. I'm one of two on board medics, and we've got quite a big medical kit on board that. So we managed to cap it with filler and take the pain away to allow me to complete the leg, really. But things didn't go quite so well when I got here to Abu Dhabi. I had it whipped out a few days ago. So yeah, a massive hole in my mouth at the moment. These are boats you would normally sail with 17, 18 people, but we've set them up to race offshore with 8 people. So. Like any sporting team, we all have dedicated positions around the boat. For me, my primary position is bowman, which is basically operating up here where I'm standing at the moment and setting up all the sail maneuvers. We carry all these sails. There's 8 sails on board, and we have to peel between these sails that are essentially the size of, I don't know, half the size of a soccer field or whatever when they're up in the air, and we've got to get one down, another one up seamlessly without losing speed, and that's kind of my primary job. But being the Volvo and we're only 8 people, I'm also a trimmer driver on board. So do a lot of driving and a lot of trimming, which is basically adjusting the sails to the wind to make the boat go as fast as possible. You know, we've got to keep improving as the race goes on. These guys, like, we're racing against the best guys in the world here, and they're all going to keep getting better. We've just got to keep getting better that little step ahead of them to keep where we are. So pressure is definitely on, and it's going to be a long race. We've got some 32,000 miles or so to go, and 6 months of racing till we get back to Europe later this year. So a lot can happen in that. It's grueling, you know. It's punishing and it's relentless. It's a normal sports game is over in an hour or 2 hours or 5 or 6 hours. We're out there pushing pretty hard for 23 days straight and 24 hours around the clock. So just the physical side of it wears you down after a while. The conditions can be everything from furious to nice and gentle like they are here in Abu Dhabi today. We get everything, and between here and the end of the race we're going to see everything from storms to massive seas to flat calm and no wind, and we've just got to deal with it. So, and like I said, 24/7, it takes its toll. We're burning in the region of 4,000 to 5,500 calories a day, and just to eat enough to keep yourself physically fit is a tough job in itself. So the sleep deprivation is pretty extreme. We can go for 2-3 days without any sleep, and then in general we'll get a payback time where you'll get your 6 or 8 hours a day, and everything's all right again for a while. But you go through some really punishing times. But the racing itself and the boats we're sailing are the most exciting yachts in the world to sail, and we're sailing in probably the biggest playground in the world. We can push these things to their absolute limits, and sometimes we find them, sometimes we stay within them. When we find the limits, it can get pretty hairy and pretty messy on board a boat like this. My name is Justin Slattery from Abu Dhabi Ocean Racing. You can watch the Volvo Ocean Race every week in TG Qatar.